Citi Field. A good matchup here for you tonight between the Cincinnati Reds and the New York Mets. Stay tuned for Mets baseball coming up next. And the next batter will be Mike Freeman. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. And it's 1-2.
One ball.
Temperature here at the park tonight, a comfy 72 degrees at first pitch. It's ball two.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
The 2-2 one more time. Gets him swinging. He struck him out. One out, base is empty. And in to swing the bat next is Jonathan India.
Third baseman, number six, Jonathan India.
The 1-2. Bases are empty, one man out. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. Nick Castellanos at the plate now, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. The 1-1. Hard on the ground towards short, reined in. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Now to the plate, Jonathan Villar. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. A high fastball is in there.
Count one and two.
This is on the ground over to first. Fielded by Votto. He'll take it to the bag himself, and the leadoff man is gone here to start the home first. Now one down with the bases empty, and that'll bring in Jeff McNeil. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Into the windup and the pitch.
That's in, ball two.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he missed with that one. It's ball four. A one-out walk here in the home first. One out, runner at first. And ready to bat next, the Wyoming native Brandon Nimmo. Takes that one a little bit low. Three balls and a strike now.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm and finding the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
So one down with a pair of runners aboard. And up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. Next for the Mets, Dominic Smith.
The left fielder, Dominic Smith.
Turned on, but it's wide of first and foul. The 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Now 2-2, two on, two out. This is when you have to make a pitch right here. The last thing you want to do is run the count full to 3-2. Then the runners are going to be off to the races.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Fouled away. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. Too high, and that cost him ball four. So runners in scoring position. And here is J.D. Davis looking to put them ahead early with this at-bat. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. And he strikes him out. So a missed opportunity at the plate as he strands three runners and the side is retired. Ready now for Cincinnati. Jesse Winker. Previous battles with Carlos Carrasco. He's gone 2-for-5. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses. Ball two. Here's a drive out to left center field. Around first, he's digging for second. And this throw gets away from him. The tag comes down, and they're going to get him at third. Aggressive base running there following some shoddy defensive play, but it doesn't work out for him. Stepping in now, Joey Votto. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And he can't connect with the 3-1 curveball, so that'll run it full. And he fouls this one off. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. Liner in there for a base hit.
Batting fifth, the center fielder, number 12, Tyler.
So now to the plate, Tyler Naquin. Swung on and fouled as it looked to make it all the way up into the concourse area. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. In now for the Reds, Tucker Barnhart. Previous battles with Carlos Carrasco. He's just 1-for-6. And this pitch misses to the Reds catcher. Now 2-1. Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side.
If I'm on the mound, a guy gets a hack off on me like that and crushes a breaking ball down the line, kind of note to self, I'm not going there again.
Hit hard down the right field line, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And this is lined hard to deep left. Smith finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Now at the plate is Michael Conforto. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Oh, and the slurve is over for strike three called. One gone. So now here is Tomas Nido.
Jumbo.
The 1-1 home. Popped him up. Votto in foul ground. Two down. So here's the Mets pitcher, Carlos Carrasco.
Carlos Carrasco.
The 1-1 home. Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Bottom of the second here with no score. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. New inning set to get underway, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Eugenio Suarez. And And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three. So here's the Reds pitcher, Sonny Gray. And we'll likely see him square around to bunt. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And the pitcher is, in fact, bunting here as he puts this one down. To second for one. The relay not in time as he beats the throw by a step. Back to the top of the Reds lineup now, and stepping in, Mike Freeman. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. There's ball four. Couple of runners on base with one down, and in to swing the bat next is Jonathan India. Count is full. Here's the pitch, and he misses again. Ball four, and that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls. Third inning, no score to this point. One pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got
just a sec now as that ball finds its way into the outfield, a base hit, and they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
The left fielder, number 33, Jesse.
Standing in now, Jesse Winker. Oh, and it misses, ball four, and that will force home a run. So up steps the former MVP, Joey Votto. Here's the 1-1 now to Votto.
Yeah, Matty, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times, or do I have to sit on something else?
There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Lazy fly ball out to center field. Nimmo has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. And he's out. Beautiful throw home to cut down the run. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring up the switch hitting shortstop, Jonathan Villar.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Scooped up. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first. So it's a runner at first as a result of the throwing error. And that'll bring in the second baseman, Jeff McNeil. Here's a bouncer foul to the left side, and the count will move ahead now to 3-2. And that will miss for ball four. So an error and a walk here to start the inning.
Up next to the head.
And here's the former first-round draft choice, Brandon Nimmo. He drew a base on balls his first time up. It's down for extra bases, and the Mets have their first hit of the game. As he arrives at second without a play, as they also push across a score to make it a one-run game. In now, Pete Alonso. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Hey, there's a ton of reasons I could give to you as to why this guy has been such a good pitcher in his career. But I think this is the biggest one. His ability to work out of nasty jams. Two guys in scoring position right here. Interested to see how he works out of this.
So next to hit is Dominic Smith. A potential tying run for him at third base.
Dominic.
The 1-2. Now he turns and smokes this one into deep center field. Catch is made. Runner tagging from third. And not in time as the run scores. Next up from New York, J.D. Davis. 0 for 1 here in the early going.
J.D. Davis.
Here's the payoff pitch. In tight, ball four. And they're at the corners now with two away. So it's first and third with two away. And up next, the left-handed hitting Michael Conforto. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Big swing, and this one's launched to right field and deep. Castellanos retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. Ball set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Tyler Naquin. And there's ball two now. Now a curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count.
Smoke the other way, high and deep to left. Around first, digging for two, and that's off the left field wall. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Up next for Cincinnati, the catcher, Tucker Barnhart.
Into the box now, Tucker Barnhart. Pulls this one high and deep to right center field. Out of here, into the visitor's bullpen. At the plate now, Eugenio Suarez. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now.
Interesting sequence of pitches right there. A real ugly swing on a ball away, and it looks like the batter has a much better idea of what he's looking for after that second pitch.
This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone. Now the 1-1 pitch. Four runs, five hits. One error on the ledger for Cincinnati so far. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And now a slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now. Ready now is Mike Freeman. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. Conforto gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And now it'll be the catcher, Tomas Nido. The 1-1. Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out. So next to bat will be Carlos Carrasco. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
Carrasco.
Mets pitcher behind at the plate with a ball and two strikes.
That's a pitch he'd like to have back. You're not going to see very many pitches like that from a pitcher of this quality. I'm sure he'd like to have that one back to take a swing at it.
So two are gone in the Mets half of the fourth, and the switch hitter Jonathan Villar will be the next to bat. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Popped him up. Barnhart moving to his left, and that retires the side. All set for the start of the inning, and set to go is the third baseman, Jonathan India. The 2-1 home.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes. Every pitcher's been there, but it doesn't make it any less frustrating or unacceptable.
Full count, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. This one's blooped out toward right center field. There to make the catch is McNeil, and there's one away. Nick Castellanos now. He's one for two in this one. The 2-2. Swing and a ground ball for VR at shortstop. And that's the second out. Two gone in the Cincinnati fifth. And next to bat will be Jesse Winker. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. Over to first, and that retires the side. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that'll bring in Jeff McNeil. Slurve, good pitch, and it's back to 2-2. And it's fouled away. Another 2-2 offering. This one's flared out toward left. And that'll get down for a base hit.
The center fielder, number 9, Brandon.
Into the box, Nimmo. Brandon Nimmo. And he takes ball 2, and it's 2-1. And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike, 2-2 now. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Right to him. There's one. On to Votto, and they get the double play. So base is empty now after the double play. And here comes the first baseman, Pete Alonso. The 1-1 home. Is strike two swinging. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Trevor May takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and standing in is the on-base machine, first baseman Joey Votto. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Now that at the plate now is Tyler Naquin. For his career in this matchup, he's just 1-for-6. He's also gone down on strikes 5 times. Hit in the air down the right field line. Right fielder is on the run. He gets there, and that's the second out. And now Tucker Barnhart comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. The 1-1. Heading out towards shallow right. Long run for the right fielder. A dive, and he brings it in. And on a fantastic play, the inning is over. Josh Osich enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and standing in the outfielder, Dominic Smith. The 2-1 home.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Hit sharply on the ground. Fielded cleanly. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. J.D. Davis, the next at bat, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. The 1-1 home. Drilled on the ground is short. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. One there. On to first, but good hustle as he's able to avoid the double play here.
The right fielder,
next to dig 30. In, Michael Conforto right flew out last time up. The 1-1 home. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. The 1-2 pitch. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. Fouled off. Here's another 2-2. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
The catcher, number
so
three.
Now into the box is Tomas Nido. He was retired Nido. Via the ground ball last time up. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and no one will get this one. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Two runs on two hits and no errors on the Mets line score so far. And another foul ball.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
But pulled in at the hot corner, and that ends the inning. Stepping in once again is Eugenio Suarez. His career numbers against this pitcher, he's only 1-for-10. He's also been a strikeout victim six times. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Tyler Stevenson will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Hey, I know the idea is to try to get the guy to swing on a 2-2 pitch, right? But that one was so low, I don't know anybody that would have swung at that pitch.
And he lays off ball four, so he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done. The 3-1. Here's a fly ball, well hit. Racing back, the right fielder. On the warning track, he makes the catch. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And in to swing the bat next is Jonathan India. Now the 1-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Fly ball out toward left center field. Nimmo will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Heath Hembree will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh. Luis Guillorme is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Here it comes. Hit hard towards center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So with that, the Mets have a runner aboard to get the inning underway.
Now that's shortstop.
To the plate now, Jonathan Villar. A 3-ball, 1-strike count to the Mets shortstop.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Count full, 3-balls and 2-strikes. Now the payoff pitch home. Line drive to center field. Naquin is right there, one down. So the next to bat will be Jeff McNeil. He steps in off a base hit in his last at bat. Skied into straightaway right. Castellanos is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So here's Brandon Nimmo. He was a double play victim last time around. Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. skied in the air to straightaway left. Winker is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Aaron Loop has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Into the box, Nicholas Castellanos. He grounded out last time up. Here's VR out there at shortstop. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. So one away here in the Reds' half of the eighth. And next to bat will be Jesse Winker. Here it comes on 1-1. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. He's got it, and he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. In is Joey Votto now. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. Cut fastball there as he manages to just foul this one away. The 2-2. Hit sharply on the ground.
The center fielder.
Stepping in now, Tyler Naquin. Now a flare out to left center. VR ranging into the outfield. He can't get there as it falls in. And now this is thrown wildly, just getting it into the infield. Throw comes in quickly from left, so even on the hit and run, they'll hold thanks to first and second here. So now to the plate, Tucker Barnhart heading out towards shallow right. And the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Brad Brock is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number six spot following the double switch. Shogo Akiyama will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch. The 1-2. Is looked at for ball number two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
Up next, to the net.
Next up, no Dominic Smith. 0-for-1 with a net. Run batted in thus far.
Smith.
2-1.
That's a good pitch to lay off right there. That cutter inside. And that is a real tough pitch for hitters to lay off of. And a lot of times, if you do swing at that cutter in, you're going to end up with some firewood and a broken bat.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Center fielder looking up, still going back. Into the bullpen and gone. At the plate, J.D. Davis. Wisely lays off the cut fastball there. It's 2-1. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Hard hit to first. And there's out number two. So two are gone in the Mets half of the eighth. And up next, the left-handed hitting Michael Conforto. Down low, two balls and a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit sharply on the ground. Scooped up. And he'll make that play look easy as the throw is in time to end the inning. A set to start the ninth in this one, and stepping up as the shortstop, Eugenio Suarez. Ready with the 1-1. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. The 1-2. Popped him up. Alonso over to his left. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Next, here is Shogo Akiyama.
Shogo Akiyama.
Two balls and a strike. Trying to bunt his way aboard, but this will get foul. Now here's the pitch. Line hard. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full 3-2.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine-hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. Next to hit is Mike Freeman. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. From the belt, kicks and deals.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two. Jonathan India digging in now. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Here it comes on 1-1. One run game here in the top of the ninth. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Throw over to first, and the runner back. And again a throw, and he'll dive back in safely. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. And he will crash into the wall, but hold on to it there for the final out of the inning. Sean Doolittle enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And next to hit is the catcher, Tomas Nido. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
The right fielder, number 18.
And now here is Jose Peraza. The 1-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two.
Hey, no shame in that. Your eyes light up when that heater comes above the belt. That's so tough to lay off of.
Fouled away. One out, nobody on. Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2. To short, reined in. Throw on to first, and the Mets are down to their final out. Mets down to their final out now. And the switch hitter Jonathan Villar will be the next to bat.
Villar.
And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. All even now, 2-2. The Mets down to their final strike. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. Barnhart finds it. Throw in time, and the ball game is over.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. The Reds took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Sonny Gray gets the W on the mound. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game tonight: for the victorious Cincinnati Reds, 4 runs, 7 hits, 2 errors.